See, he was in Taiwan. Well, we're done.
Yeah, we're gonna mute you folks and
okay.
Get into the service. Yeah, we'll do. Yeah. Jesus. Where's it go? Where'd it go? Podium. Right here.
There we go. We got it. And volume. Oh, you got it.
Volume.
All right.
Good morning, church. Announcements today. The covenanting service will be on September 11th at 6 p.m. At this service, we'll share the sacrament of communion, so there will be no communion on September 4th. Following the service, members will have the opportunity to share in refreshments and formally meet the members of the Hackshaw family. We're looking forward to an enriching service and a time of great fellowship. Anyone that is interested in that has basic sketching skills or knows anyone that has, please talk to Pam.
To test it. Are you hearing me? One to test it. Good morning, church. Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries today? Anyone celebrating? Tomorrow is your birthday. Please stand and let us celebrate with you. And Jean, sorry. Oh, we're asking him to stand so that we can celebrate with him. Say to you, happy birthday. Any anniversary? I know August and June and July and September are the months of weddings. No? I'm going to break a protocol here, but I'm asking for your prayers for our sister Elaine Witter, who will be doing surgery sometime this week, eye surgery. And let us together hold her up in our prayers. We pray that God will go before you, be with the doctors, hold their hands, prepare the equipment, that all will go well. And we hope to see you back here next Sunday. Thank you. Do we have any prayer requests today for the prayers of the people? Anyone would like to name someone? Any requests for prayers? I'm listening. The homeless. Any other prayer requests? Okay. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. In a confused, dark, and lonely world, God offers light and companionship. He brings order where there is chaos. This is the God we adore. Our faithful, unchangeable friend. My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you. Let us pass the peace as we are able. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. The call to worship printed in the order. Please note your response. O God, you knew us before we were born.
Throughout our lives, you have gone with us.
You know our reluctance to speak and work for you.
But you say, believe in yourselves and you can do it.
We have no reason to fear, no reason to hang back.
God will give us words to say and the confidence to carry out our faithful task.
Let us stand and sing lustily that beautiful hymn, Jesus, you have come to the lake shore. Jesus, you have come to the lake shore, looking neither for wealthy nor wise ones. You only ask me to follow humbly. Oh, Jesus, with your eyes you have searched me, and while smiling have spoken my name. My boat's left on the shoreline behind me. By your side, I will seek other seas. You know so well my possessions. My boat carries no gold and no weapons. You will find there my nets and searched me, and while smiling have spoken my name. Now my boat's left on the shoreline behind me. By your side I will seek other seas. You need my hands full of caring, my boat carriers to
constant love that keeps on giving. Oh Jesus, with your eyes you have searched me, and while smiling you have spoken my name. Now my boat's left on the shoreline behind me, by your side I will seek other seas. You who have fished other oceans, ever longed for by souls who are waiting, my loving friend, as thus you call me. Oh Jesus, with your eyes you have searched me, and while smiling have spoken my name. Now my boat's left on the shoreline behind me, by your side I will seek other seas.
Let us pray. O Lord, you unveil hidden things. You make clear misunderstood things. You revive forgotten things. You, O Lord, are the great revealer, the mysterious bard. The strange troubadour of love. The storyteller spinning wondrous tales of a great devotion. The poet composing a universe where the creator romances creation. Something old, something new. Your revelation, O God, is at once eternal and momentarily, at once complete and fragmentary. On it goes, and forever it comes, as it always has gone, as it always shall come again. But we like first disciples, are unprepared for your revelation. We look for a savior. We want new law. So long as it runs only so deep as the engravings on a stone tablet, we demand a new revelation. So long as it retains enough of the old that few changes are required. But this Jesus, his law cuts beneath tablets and appearances to lifeblood. His revelation is fulfilled not only in life, but in death. O Lord, send your spirit. Open us to your singing and your speaking and your sending this day, lest In not seeing it today, we be blind to see it tomorrow. Amen. The hymn, I Feel the Wind of God Today. Good morning again, church, and welcome to worship. Welcome to all those who are listening to us via Zoom. We trust that the worship this morning will be a blessing. And we notice that most of the hymns and the prayers are focusing on some sort of call, the use of your gift, your feeling of God's presence. It is a sign that this is what we are focusing on this morning. And this morning, I want to talk about, and I'm not no expert on it, but the importance of a mother carrying a baby in her womb. All that psychologists and others, the experts have said, have been taking place there when the child is in the womb. And for those of you who have carried babies, it's a special time, ain't it? Hello? Not for all mothers. Some mothers have had terrible times, like gone to the hospital for more than 4 times during pregnancy because of pregnancy difficulties. I know of that. But there are mothers who just have an amazing time feeling that babe kicking and moving and jumping and dancing, and sometimes even reacting to daddy's voice while the child is in the womb. Now, it is believed that there is where the bond starts between the parents and the child. So as soon as a child is born, comes into this world, And daddy speaks, and mommy speaks, he or she opens her eyes wide because recognize those voices. And I have had that experience. Sometimes I come home and my wife would be sitting in the chair, and as soon as I start making noise in the house, we could see the children, first Azrael and then Anaya, bulging, pushing. They're jumping to and rejoicing. That's a special moment. It's a special gift. It is something that we just cannot explain. We come up with theories, we come up with all kinds of thoughts, but we just cannot explain it because it is really beyond our comprehension. A sign that God is there working, doing something that we cannot do, causing something to happen that we cannot cause to happen. The presence of God is right there in the womb. And that presence would never leave us. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Today we are so appreciative of your presence, O God. You fulfilling your promises to us. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Even when we turn against you, you are there, beckoning us, calling us by name, befriending us, inviting us into new relationship with you. Even when we feel bitter and angry, and certain things are unfathomable, your spirit is with us, urging us on. First, reminding us of our limitations. We can't know everything. We won't explain everything. But we can trust you, Lord, for you will see us through. Teach us how to trust you and to wait on you. Amen. Thanks again, and I want to, at this moment, welcome all those who are worshiping with us for the first time. We have Joyce and Corwin Johnson, who have come all the way from Scarborough to be with us, to worship with us. It's the children's special auntie and uncle, so they call them, but they have been good friends since we worked in Grenada, and they are also Canadians. So they are here worshiping with us for the first time. Let us welcome them. The readings from the Holy Scripture.
Good morning, church. The first scripture reading would be taken from Jeremiah 1, verses 4 to 10. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations." Then I said, "Ah, Lord God, truly I do not know how to speak, for I am only a boy." But the Lord said to me, "Do not say, 'I am only a boy,' for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and you shall speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." Then the Lord put his hand on me and touched my mouth. And the Lord said to me, "Now I have put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms, to pluck up and to pull down, to destroy and to overthrow, to build and to plant." The next reading will be taken from Luke 13, verses 10 to 17. Now he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath, and just then there appeared a woman with a spirit that had crippled her over 18 years. She was bent over and was quite unable to stand up straight. When Jesus saw her, he called her over and said, "Woman, you are set free from your ailment." When he laid his hands on her, immediately she stood up straight and began praising God. But the leader of the synagogue, indignant because Jesus had cured on the Sabbath, kept saying to the crowd, "There are 6 days on which work ought to be done. Come on those days and be cured, and not on the Sabbath day." But the Lord answered him and said, "You hypocrites, does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his donkey from the manger and lead it to the water? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 long years, be set free from this bondage on the Sabbath day?" When he said this, all his opponents were put to shame, and the entire crowd was rejoicing at all the wonderful things being done by him. This is the word of the Lord.
But thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk, dear Lord, close to thee. Is my plea daily walking close to thee? Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Through this world of toils and snares, I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. When my feeble life is o'er, for me will be no more. Lord, close to Thee. Just a closer walk with Thee. Grant it, Jesus, is my plea.
Another Sunday morning, another opportunity to worship, another time when we reflect on the grace of God as God moves among us and God calls us. Another time to give thanks. For indeed we are unworthy. But God sticks with us. He's not giving up. He's walking with us. As a parent, God nurtures us. As a mother, He feeds us. As a father, He protects us. God is everything. There's a hymn writer who wrote a beautiful song that says, Jesus is all the world to me. My life, my joy, my all. Let us pray. We wait to hear Your word, O God. Speak, for Your servants are listening. Amen. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And before you were, I consecrated you. Two very powerful verbs used in this text. Formed and consecrate. Form suggests that God alone can create something out of nothing. Genesis 1, when the earth was formless and without shape, and there was nothing there. Genesis says, God spoke the word, and the world came into existence. A chaotic world was formed. And order became the thing of the day. Jeremiah uses this same concept to say that God is still creating. But he went a bit further. He's saying that God is using human beings in the process of creation. Listen to how he puts it. Before I formed you in the womb, which means that the mother is present. Human beings become a part of God's creation. And God is working through human beings to continue God's creation. This is a sign that creation is not static. It is not stagnant. Creation is dynamic. And it continues even up to today. I formed you in the womb. The other verb that is used is the word consecrate. I choose you. It means that all our gifts, our mission, our vision are to be directed by God. In other words, we cannot use our gifts rightly until we are in sync with God's justice, God's love, God's way. Our prayers and our actions should be devoted to understanding and doing the will of God. Form and consecrate in this text means that part of God's will is for us to build and nurture all of God's creation. What this means is that our duty to ourselves and to the rest of God's creation ought to be to nurture, to build up, and to encourage. We all have those gifts. And we must use them to the glory of God. We must do all in our power to work towards a harmonious, beautiful life. Life itself is a gift. It is not something to be frittered away in the busyness and press of this commercial world. To be harmonious calls for us, or to be in harmony calls for us to spend time in meditation and reflection, and also to spend time in seeking out God's justice. Consecration means that we are mandated to love and build according to God's way in God's world. I want us to take note that the consecration according to Jeremiah took place in the womb. Jeremiah said, "The Lord's word came to me and said, before I formed you in the womb, I consecrated you. I knew you. I chose you. I called you to be mine." These days, I am baffled because of all the senseless killings that are taking place in our world. Human beings using guns and bombs to destroy one another. Guns and bombs should never have been created in the first place. They are destructive to humans' life. And it is only out of hatred and anger that human beings use these weapons. Which says to us that hatred, anger, bitterness, love for power, always wanted to be in control, are not in accordance to the will of God. Anything that destroys life, that causes human beings to feel that life is not a sacred gift, when that thing is used, is not meant for human beings to use it in the way they use it to destroy life. Jeremiah's text is very clear. It is beyond Jeremiah. It is for us as well. We are all formed and we are all consecrated. Within you, there is that understanding of justice, that gift to love and to care for and to nurture. You have it. We all have it because God has given us. And he has shown us how to use them. The gift to love, to care, to nurture, to be in sync with his universe. We have the wonderful gift of love. And we must share that gift. On the other hand, when we ignore the gift of love in us, we turn to the other side. We build hatred. We nurture grievances. And we seek power. Not only to be in control of ourselves, but power to be in control of others. The warning comes from the gospel. And it came from Jeremiah. You will not get the power from God to control others. No matter what position you hold in this world, God will not give you the power to determine how people must use their gifts and when they should use their gifts. So the teacher in the synagogue was angry when Jesus used Jesus' gift to be a blessing to a woman who was sick. And he narrowed it down by using the excuse of the law. It is the Sabbath, and she comes for healing on the Sabbath day. The text says that no one will get the power to determine how others should use their gifts. We are all part of God's creation. And the best thing we can do in God's creation, as one created by God, is to create the space for others to be empowered so that they could use their gifts. I formed you, said God, not human beings. I consecrated you, said God to Jeremiah. Therefore, I gave you the power to tear down and to build up. Whether the kings of the world like it or not, this is my power and my gift to you. Go and use those gifts. We all will be making a mistake if we turn away from the love within us and let hatred reign. If instead of using our gifts to empower, we use our gifts to control and to belittle others. Instead of nurturing, we destroy. Jesus says, the greatest commandment, my beloved, is to love the Lord your God and to love your neighbor as yourself. Let us pray. In a world that is divided, where there is so much segregation, a world that is mad with hatred and violence and anger, where we claim our space and keep others at a distance so that they would not intrude on our space. In a world where the young are seeking the loving arms of the adults, and a word of advice and encouragement we pray for your healing, Lord. healing not only from physical ailment, but healing from the spiritual sickness that we nurture in this world. The injustice, the grudges we nurture, the racial barriers, the national barriers. The economic status. We seek your healing. For we know that we are all one, formed and consecrated by you. And as a church, we open our hearts this day to allow your love to flow through us. Bring an end to the anger, the division, the hatred, the envy, and the strife that exists in our societies. We depend on you, O God, for that end to come. With loving gratitude and in prayer, we lift up those named before us. We pray for Eileen's children, that you may be with them in their going and in their coming, in their times of reflection and rest, and in their times of busyness at work and at play. May they sense your presence and glorify your name. We pray for the homeless among us, in our societies, those who at this summertime are sleeping on the street corners, not knowing where their next meal would come from, and if they would ever own a shelter. With the high cost for housing and shelter, we pray that you will open a door for the homeless that no one could shut. Bless them as they walk the streets and as they seek justice and love. We pray for our youth, soon our children would be going back to school, and there was a time when we could take comfort that we are home or at work, and our children are in a safe place in school. These days, many are targeting schools with their guns and their knives, their weapons. There are many school children or students who are falling victims to the anger and rage of young men and women in our societies. We pray for those who are carrying around guns and knives with the hope to do others harm. May they come to their senses. And when our students return to school, may they find a school, an environment conducive for learning, a place of peace and love, where lives are nurtured and built. So as we go forth with a mission, go with us, Lord. And may we contribute to a harmonious and loving environment. In the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Let's pray.
And deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We receive our offering. You free us to offer the best we are able, O God.
The best of our gifts, the best of our striving, the best of our friendship, the best of our faithfulness, the best of our abilities, the best of our will for justice, the best for our eternal hopefulness.
Nothing is offered to God in vain. God will receive our offerings and richly bless them. Amen. For him, I, the Lord of sea and sky.
Sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord, it is I, Lord, I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me, I will in my heart. I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Go now in peace.
Go now in peace. Never be afraid. God will go with you each hour of every day. Go now in faith. Steadfast, strong, and true. Know he will guide you in all you do. Go now in love and show you believe. Reach out to others so all the world can see. From above, go now in peace, in faith, and in love. Amen. Amen.
Blessed week to one and all. Enjoy the summer weather. We are still having good weather. Enjoy it. God be with you.